Once you understand how layers work in Chief Architect and how to access them with your layer display options, you can add to your productivity by using layer sets. To access layer sets, here in the layer display options, you can see under layer sets, the current active layer set is the default set. And as you can see, there's already several layer sets saved in the profile plan that is used when you first open up the Chief Architect program. Layer sets group all of the layers in your plan with some layers turned off and some layers turned on, as indicated here with the blue check mark under the DISP or display column. For instance, if we go down to the electrical layers in the default set, you'll notice that the electrical and the electrical connection layers are not displayed on my screen. However, if I click here and go down to select the electrical layer set, you can see that in this layer set, they are displayed. I'll go ahead and click OK, and we can activate the electrical layer set by using your active layer set control. I'll click on the drop-down to see the same list of existing layer sets. We'll select the electrical set to make it active on my screen. In the electrical set, the layers that are not relevant to an electrical plan are turned off, but all of the electrical layers that are relevant are turned on. We'll go back to the layer display options and we'll turn on this last electrical layer for the labels by clicking in the DISP column. This changes only the electrical set, unless you click on Modify All Layer Sets. You'll notice that if I go back here to the default layer set, those three layers are still turned off. You can also change other attributes to each layer, specific to a single layer set. For instance, you'll notice here that the electrical layers are all red in the default set and in the electrical layer set. But here in the electrical layer set, I'll select the electrical layer, hold down my Shift key to select all three of these layers at the same time. Then I'll change the color by going down here to Color and click on the red tab. I'll select a different color for all my electrical layers, click OK, and now you'll notice that all three of these layers are now green. But again, that's only specific to the electrical set. If I go back to the default set, they're still red. That principle works the same for all attributes of every layer. The settings for whether the layer is displayed, whether it's included in your material list, whether or not it's locked, the color attribute, the line weight, line style, and the text style that's assigned to each and every layer. All of these settings can be different from one layer set to the next. Now, if we go back to our electrical set, click OK, you can see the changes that we've made in our electrical layer set. All of the electrical objects are green. The profile plan that opens when you first open up Chief Architect includes these layer sets. However, you can create your own. For instance, I'll start here with the default layer set, and I'll copy that set to create a new one. This one I'll call my Furnishings Layers. That will give me a duplicate of the default set, including all of its settings, and I'll make a few changes. I'll go down here to the Furniture Layers and turn on the Furniture Interiors layer. I'll click OK, then we'll make the Furniture Layer set active. When I click on this one, you can see that the furniture is now displayed on my screen. In addition to accessing your layer sets through your layer display options, you can also access the active layer display set through your active layer display options here on the right side of your screen. The active layer display options is turned off and on with a toggle switch. Here in your toolbar, you'll find the active layer display options button. If I click on this, it'll turn it off. Click on it again, and you'll see the small check mark, which indicates it's displayed on your screen. Here you can edit the layers and the layer settings, specifically for the active layer set. You can also access your layer sets if we go to Tools, to Layer Settings, and here to Layer Set Management. This is where you can redefine your layer sets or create new ones, copy existing sets, rename them, or delete them, as long as they're not the current active layer set or used in other default settings. You can learn more about default settings in additional online training videos. Different layer sets can be used not only in your floor plan view, but different layer sets are used in your camera views. I'll create a full camera here of the living room. Here in the camera view, you'll notice that the camera view set of layers is active. You'll also notice that none of my interior furniture is displayed in this view. If we go back to the floor plan view, where we're using the furnishings layers, you can see that the furniture is displayed. In the camera view, I'll go here to my active layer display options, go down to the Fs in the layer list, and turn on furniture interior. Now my furniture is displayed in this view. I'll close this view, and then we'll create an elevation view of the outside of the building. In the elevation view, you can see that we're using this section view set of layers. Again, you can edit this set of layers by going to your active layer display options. I'll go here to the windows layers and turn off the window labels. Window labels are no longer displayed. With layer sets, you can display whatever you need to see on your screen with a single click of a button. So understanding and using saved layer sets will help to improve your working productivity. In an additional online training video, we'll show you how you can use layer sets when sending views to layout.